And Steve Rhodes, what's going on?
And in, you know, in Florida, but specifically in Tampa, holding another PGA Tour event. You guys have had a bunch over there, and great to see the fans back. You know, if you watch like last week's PGA tournament, or not, maybe it was last week, might have been the seniors or the women they were playing in California.
Yes.
Sparse. Nobody there. Come to Florida, you get all kinds of crowds and just
we're,
great.
We're
to
open, folks. We're definitely open.
I've got to imagine where you're at. So you in the St. Pete area, you guys have an outdoor restaurant. A nightlife environment, very much like we have here in Delray Beach on our avenue. And Tom, right, we're way busier. We had been up until probably about a few days ago, way busier than years ago.
Yeah, there's no doubt. I'm trying to figure out, you know what's so cool here, folks? Like, no one's left. It looks to me, I literally just got caught in a little traffic. Okay, that's why I just changed two different shirts, folks. Okay, because I had green on the other shirt. So I did wear this Friday, but guess what, folks? I had to change because I was disappearing. But anyway, that's what I was saying. Man, this hasn't changed. Listen, and I'm digging it. That's the bottom line. Come on down. You know,
Yeah, you kind of see it here. One of the ways that I kind of measure what's going on is through the golf clubs.
Yes.
And so when the economy is so-so or okay during the summertime, so down here, like you're saying, you know, it's very seasonal, or there's
right,
a lot of seasonal
it
business.
It is, for sure. Right.
Yeah.
Oh, it has been.
Yes. And so in the summertime, because of that seasonality, they'll go ahead and open up the clubs to, you know, do summer type programs.
Right.
I haven't seen summer programs being offered. So it just tells you how busy.
That's good to know, man. Yes. That, you know, you're right. And it hasn't been offered here either. Wow. That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So just it tells you about the strength. I know it does. It's not that, you know, the strength, everybody's not appreciating the strength or what have you. But we just happen to be in a nice environment here.
No, that's a good one. I think that's a subtle, very good one, man, because that's the real deal, man. Yeah. Right.
Yes. So, look, I thought what you would do. We've done this, obviously, over the course of time. Take a look at the current cycle that we're in, or the seasonal cycle, which in essence begins in May, the sell in May. Everybody's familiar with that. And for folks, the reason why there's this sell in May cycle, or whatever you might want to refer to it, is because of, if you just simply take a look at how the Dow has performed on average, and this chart here is the last 86 years, what you'll see is that the Dow bottoms typically the end of January, moves higher into May, and then moves lower into October, and then higher into back into January. Now, on this cycle here, the sell in May typically doesn't start on day number one. The average has been right around May 19th. And then we see the market move lower typically into the end of June, a nice spike higher into July, and then finally that big thump down into October. So this is the typical seasonal cycle. So the question should be, everybody should ask themselves this question. I'm asking myself this question. Are we at a top now? Well, let's go back and take a look at other May timeframes. Let's go look at the last May timeframe. If we take a look at the 2020 so-called sell in May cycle, there was never one of the topping patterns that I use for newsletter subscribers that I talk about during the Trader Zed show. And if we take a look at this little rectangle area here, here is our sell in May. You can see really nothing and no top that was to speak of in 2020, and the market continued to move higher. So not all sell in Mays turn out to be a selling cycle. If you look at 2019, in 2019, the sell in May cycle formed a Rhodes Momentum Indicator top. That's where price is moving higher, doing less relative energy. I teach subscribers that. If people are interested in learning, if they subscribe to the newsletter, there are going to be workshops that they can, they'll walk them exactly through this pattern. The blue arrows here are identifying the first blue arrow is when the pattern formed, then when it was confirmed, and was confirmed again with these bearish reversal candles, price moves down into June as normal. So 2019 has one of the different sell signals that I look for. How about 2018? Well, in 2018, the sell in May cycle never generated a topping pattern. We had price kind of move sideways, pull back a bit, get a little bit of consolidation. It did bottom in June, like it typically does with the TD9 count. That's one of the other bottoming patterns that we have. In 2017, the sell in May cycle never generated a topping signal. price continued to move higher. 2016, the sell and May cycle did form a Rhodes-Mintum indicator top. And what it did, what, Tom, was it led to an A to B equals CD to downside, kind of by these black diagonal lines here. Also formed wave number 7. That's part of Basil Chapman's work out here when it did form its bottom in June. But in 2016, the sell and May cycle formed a topping pattern. 2015, the sell and May cycle formed a TD9 count top. It did it on May 19th, led to lower prices. In this case here, those lower prices went into August. 2014, sell and May cycle never formed a Rhodes-Mintum indicator top. It's inside this little square out here, and prices just simply continued to move higher. 2013, the sell and May cycle formed a large A to B equals CD, topped out with this nice little bear sash candle. Price moves lower into June. 2012, the sell and May cycle forms a Rhodes-Mintum indicator top way back here on the left-hand side. That top was then confirmed. This took place on April 2nd. Then in May, what we had here was we had a nice A to B equals CD pattern that tested that. So we also had like a double top out there. Price goes ahead and moves lower. So the topping patterns were in place. In 2011, the sell and May cycle formed a TD9 count top. Price moves lower into the June timeframe out here. 2010, the sell and May cycle forms a Rhodes-Mintum indicator top. So if everybody has been following along with us so far, we have periods of times in May where we have definite confirmed topping signals, and those have led to moves lower into June. We also had some consolidation periods where we never got the topping signal. So the real question should be, okay, Steve-O, where are we now? Well, if we take a look at 2021, this snapshot was taken about a half an hour ago. There is no topping pattern that is in play. There's an A to B equals CD pattern that would finish off in about the 35,000-ish type range, maybe 34,750. But what we don't have right now on May 3rd that we typically have on the other sell in May cycles that actually generate and move to lower lows in June is an absolute topping signal. Well, at least one of the topping signals that I look for. Does it mean it can't top? It just doesn't have the topping pattern that I look for. And as I go back to find in throughout May and try to figure out which ones worked and which ones didn't, guess what? It's like every other trading day or week out here. When we get a topping pattern, we just kind of follow the structure out here. So we don't have one in place right now. But let's not forget, the sell in May doesn't really top out until a few weeks from now.
And what's so cool here, folks, okay, when you get Steve's newsletter, right, all this information that he just went through, and this is really important, okay, because you can see that he just went almost 10 years, okay?
Yeah.
You get that information, okay? So come on over to our website at TFNN. You're going to see right under featured content, Mastering Probability. Hit that button. You want a great education. You want a great, basically, backup as to where we are. It's there. Great job, Steve, man. Seriously.
Thank